Welcome to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. I am giving demo of Digital Lab Station. Its order code is 33506. Firstly, I am describing the panel. This block is for the function generator block. We can vary the frequency from 1 Hz to 10 kHz. This is for generation of different waveforms and this is for variation of amplitude. This is the variable DC power supply. From plus 15 volts to minus 15 volts. This is the DC power supply at 5 volts. These are two function switches. These press switches are the pulsar switches to give pulsar to the different circuits. This is the 8 data switches for inputs. These are the output 8 buffered LED display. This is the voltmeter. This is the 2 digit 7 segment display. This is DIP switch. And this is the BNC socket. Moving on to the experiment procedure of the Digital Lab Station. Firstly, I am starting with how to perform different logic gates using this Digital Lab Station. For this purpose, I am taking the OR gate IC, that is 7432, and I am inserting this IC in the pins of the breadboard like this. Now, I am taking input from its first pin. Always remember that from the left side of this cut, we will start the counting of the pin. So, this is the first pin and I am inserting it. The first input. For the second input, I am inserting it in the second pin. And for the output, I am inserting in the third pin. Now, grounded on the seventh pin. You can provide the ground from here, DC power supply, and provide the 5 volts power supply at the 14th pin. You can consult the truth table from the lab manual. Now I am switching on the power. As you can see, at 1-1, output is 1. At 1-1-0, the output is 1. At 0 0 1, the output is 1, and when the both inputs are 0, the output is 0. Similarly, you can perform all the other logic gates. Coming on to our next experiment, that is how to prove De Morgan theorems using this Digital Lab Station. For the purpose, I am using the theorem 10 of lab manual, that is A dot B bar is equals to A bar plus B bar. For the purpose, I am using the IC 7408 and 7404. I am inserting these ICs in the breadboard like this. Firstly, I have inserted the 7408 and now I am inserting the 7404. For the figure, you can consult the lab manual, that is figure 2.2.10. And now connect the first pin of 7408 to the first input. Connect the second pin of 7408 to the second input and connect the third pin, that is output of 7408 to the you have to use wires for this jumpers, so you can connect in breadboards. Connect the third pin to the first pin of 7404. Now for the output, connect the second pin of 7404 to the output. Now using a jumper, connect the ground, that is 7th pin, of both the pins, both the ICs, and connect them with the ground. Now connect the 14th pin of both the ICs and then connect it with the power supply. Now switch on the circuit. For the truth table, you can consult the lab manual. At the 00, the output will be 00, the output will be 1. At 01, the output will be 1. At 110, the output will be 1. And at 11, the output will be 0. This was all about this theorem. Similarly, you can prove the other De Morgan's theorem.